finish the Datio Mochin. Especially when he's commentating on Man United. Fucking hell. That Mark Hughes. He's only got a kick-off and Mochin's going on about an inch-perfect pass. It's right though, isn't it?
All right. The media love United, all right. Yeah, but all that goes back to the Munich disaster, doesn't it?
Yeah, that was 20-odd years ago. I don't mean it was bad news in that way, but... created all this United legend. Pisses me off.
Well, they did stop Everton from doing a double. I suppose we should be thankful for that.
Yeah, well, had to do some good, didn't he? Anyway, let's not talk about it, then, eh? I'll be happy, just as long as we keep on winning, especially tonight's game.
Not long to go now. Only, what, 7 hours? And the coach leaves for Brussels at 1 o'clock, doesn't he? So that gives us 20 minutes. I wonder what Teddy and Mitch are doing now.
I said they were going to see the sights. Whatever they might be. Bleed nil. Oh, Brussels has got more going for it than Ostend. Like a crippled version of Vril. Telly's crap as well.
I'm not complaining. It's got a few bars and that's all I'm bothered about.
Yeah, it's a pity he didn't go to Paris or Rome, you know. Some of the sights there. Mind you, no matter where you went, you always bumped into a crowd of Liverpoolians. Up the Eiffel Tower. In the Colosseum. Some of them even got in the Vatican.
Go away.
All half-pissed like, but nah, it was a good laugh.
Yeah, but they got into a bit of trouble last year in Rome, though.
Yeah. Yeah, that was bad news, that, actually. Then again, you know, it wasn't the Liverpoolians. I'm telling you, these Itars can be a right share of bastards if things don't go their way. They had bricks, bottles, knives, the lot. Oh, shit myself.
Those Itars we met last night were all right. Seemed like a decent crew.
It's like most football fans everywhere, isn't it? Most of them only there for the game. You always get your dickheads, though. I suppose you've got to expect a bit of trouble nowadays, but I thought it was only the British that had the loonies.
Well, once you start fighting over a game of football, lad, that's the time to pack it in.
When you're right there.
Can't you get a picture on that thing?
How many towels did you bring with you?
Only the one. It's in the plastic bag over there. Yeah, it's a bit damp.
A bit damp? It's friggin' soaking. Jesus, it doesn't smell too sweet either.
Oh, shut up. It's a long trip over here, wasn't it? When we were right out on the air, weren't we? It's bound to get a bit sweaty. There's a tin of talc in the back there. Throw a bit of that on it. It'll kill the smell a bit.
Bleeding hell, Ralph. Thought you might have brought more than one of everything.
It's a football match we're going to. Not a bleeding royal wedding. What do you want to get tarted up for, anyway?
It's not a matter of getting tarted up. It's just a case of keeping clean.
Yeah, well, I've had a shave, put a clean shirt on. Besides, all the gear you threw into the bags didn't leave much room for towels.
How many shirts have you brought with you?
Only two in that one.
Hey, you never know what might happen tonight, Ralph. If we go to a club later on, we might box off. We won't be pulling any bears if we smell like a sumo wrestler's jockstrap.
Oh, aye. When was the last time you had a sniff at a sumo wrestler's jockstrap?
No, you know what I mean.
Anyway, when we win tonight, I'll be getting so chemicked, I won't be able to handle myself, never mind a woman.
I worry about you.
Oh, what do you worry about me for, Eddie?
Well, I like football. I like Liverpool. But with you, it's the be-all and end-all. It wouldn't matter to you if the world was ending, just as long as Liverpool win this game, so...
Hey, as far as I'm concerned, the world will have ended if Liverpool get beat tonight. Hey, you'd be the same if it wasn't working so far away. You had to stay at home and put up with all the bleeding Evertonians.
Oh, don't be at it. You wouldn't work in Saudi with me because you'd miss watching Liverpool. You've always been nuts about them. Well, I'm only here for a good time, and if I do cop it a bit of scare tonight, you'll have to shack up in someone else's room because they'll be smuggling it back to this place.
No, I. And what if we both cop off? What are we going to do? Take it in turns.
Oh, frig, I'm going to wipe the ale.
What's left anyway?
Oh! Scream! bitch!
Ah! All right, Ed.
Oh. All right, Ralph. What are you doing here, mate? Posing for Penthouse?
What are you trying to tell your Ralphie?
Oh, you've been on the air, have you?
Yeah, he's been celebrating getting a ticket for the game. Our coach driver waiting to Brussels. Got a load of them.
Yeah, well, he won't be in any fit state to see the game if he has any more beer. Heavy handed little gift, yeah.
The chance were bevy there, Ralph,
or what? You think you can handle it, yeah? Oh, yeah, yeah, I think Geddy's hidden him in the bag over there.
Nice one, mate.
How much were your tickets? Over the odds, Betty?
Aye, jeez. Double the price. Or shoot the coach driver, she's...
He was a shifty-eyed wee bastard, no? Probably got him for face value, which they make a few bob for himself.
Yeah, have a look. We're in Z block. Is that by you and Eddie?
Yeah, we're in X and Y. 300 francs. A driver charge you double, eh? Everybody on the coach buy one.
Aye, as far as I know. I'm not so bothered, do I? I just want to make sure I see the game.
Do you know about Fagan?
Yeah. Yeah, some arsehole talking in the bar last night, saying that he was retiring. Just a rumour, though, isn't it?
No, lad, he spewed it.
Go away.
Honest to God, mate, this will be his last game tonight. We were talking to these lads we had this morning, they had the English papers with them. It's all over the papers, like. Fagan's thrown his hand in.
That's a surprise, isn't it? Must have scored there, then.
According to the papers, he's had it planned since February. It's all down to him feeling like he's told to carry on, no? Seems pretty straightforward. He just wants out.
And you reckon Dalglish should be the new manager?
Oh, behave yourself. He's too valuable as a player. He's got bags of football left
on. Well, it wouldn't surprise me. It'd be typical of the English. You pay a poxy 400 grand for a player, get the best out of you as a striker, then you get him to play like a genius in midfield. And when he's knocking on a wee bit, you're turning him into your manager. And probably a player manager at that as well, eh? And that scores are supposed to be the thrifty ones. Wouldn't surprise me if he'd paint a fucking Stansfield during the summer.
You're just jealous because Celtic couldn't hang on to him, Paul.
You're fucking right, Paul. Mm. Hey, if you'd have got him for 4 million, you would have got him cheap.
Mm. You could be on, you know. I mean, Kenny, he's obviously got a good footballing brain, hasn't he? And the crowd love him. Yeah, it could be a good move, that. I pity about old Fagan, though. He's done well for us.
We're going to work it right up your ventures tonight, aren't we, Ralph?
Don't be so confident, Tony. The Italians are no pushovers. There's nothing in the bag about an ice cream. I'm telling you,
he won't get a sniff. Will he, Ralph?
Well, like Mitch says, it'd be a tough game, all right. But if I didn't think we'd win, I wouldn't be here, would I?
And we're going to sail through it.
Champions of Europe. Yeah.
Never any problems, eh, Toddy? How do you think he'd react if we lost?
I've never seen us lose a cup final, mate. Never. Bruges in 78, West Ham in 81 in the League Cup. And then Spurs, Man United, Neffin, all Milk Cup finals. And we didn't lose one of them.
And we won't lose tonight.
Aye, I knew how Kenny Dalglish for those games.
That's the trouble with you younger fellas. It's been success all the way. You haven't seen him go through a bad patch like me. I remember when you were in the second division.
Oh, fucking hell, Ralph. I wasn't even born then, how can I remember that?
Hey, dark days here, Ralph. That's going back a wee, by the way.
Right, about 23 years. Mind you, I only seen him for a couple of seasons he were down there. But some fellas I know lost in the full 8 years they were in the second division, and they were bad times, I'm telling you.
There'd be suicides in Glasgow Celtic if I got relegated. Our idea of a bad patch is losing the toss 2 weeks on. Going to season without a trophy. That's a major disaster. But getting relegated? That's unthinkable.
That's what I'm saying to Toddy, yeah. How would you react to failure?
Turn it in, will you? For fuck's sake. You're putting the mockers on his ear, aren't you? Anyway, even if we were in the second division, I'd still be supporting us. We lost twice to Everton this season, but I still went the match.
Big fucking deal. You're a real diehard, you aren't you, Todd? We lost twice. I'm talking about losing twice to loads of teams. Not just a couple of derby matches. Hey, would you still be parading around in your hat and scarf if we're as bad as Blackpool?
Oh, yeah, well, we're not as bad as Blackpool, are we? Anyway, if you're such a shit-hot supporter, where's your colours? At least I wear mine, like, you know, I'm proud to be a Liverpoolian, you know.
People know exactly what you are as soon as you speak, Toddy. The colours just excuse you.
Yeah, fucking right. Hey, so you don't see your colours, mate.
Yeah, that's all I've got to me.
Where did you get this, mate? An antique shop?
Wembley, 65.
Hey, I was only two then.
Cheeky bastard.
1965. That was the year you won the cup, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I remember seeing St. John's goal on the box. But, why have you brought that with you, Ralph?
We had to keep them things in quarantine, mate.
Yeah, it's probably sentimentality or superstition. I've always worn this for our big games. My aunt fella bought this for me the year we won the cup. She didn't wear a scarf for the match. How did I die? This was Wembley, and you had to wear something at Wembley, didn't you?
Did you and your father go to the games together?
Nah. My dad was an Anfield Road man. I always went on the cop. But that year, he managed to get 2 tickets for the final. Hey, God knows what he paid for them. Bought them off the local bookie. Mm-hmm. I was 16 and working at the time, like, but... Nah, he just wanted to mug me. You know, to be my first final.
Mug you?
Getting mugged in them days, sorry, meant someone gave you a few bob. Or treated you to something. It didn't mean he kicked me head in and got off of me bleeding tank. Yeah. Anyway, as we're walking down Wembley Way, stopped. Bought me this. Told me to wear it for luck.
Well, I must have worked, eh? Because you beat Leeds.
Yeah. All right. What a day that was. Won the league the year before, like, but... I won in the cup. That was the real beginning, though. That was the day we became a great club. The crowd, the team, Shankly. The old story picked up steam from then on in. This has been with me ever since. You see, Toddy, you don't have to wear fancy dress at the match, lad. Just as long as your heart's in the right place, that's as much as you need.
How come your kid wears all the gear then?
Yeah, it's just a novelty to our Eddie, isn't he? He just likes the piss ups of the matches, doesn't he? He's no great fan. Mind you, I've been knackered with Adam this time.
Why's that, Ralph?
Well, I'm out of work, aren't I? Didn't have a life for this trip, like, but Eddie came home from Saudi a couple of weeks ago, you know, a bit flush, like, decided to mug me.
Suppose I'm lucky, eh? I've got your job.
What, why? What'd you do?
I went to a bank.
I'd hate to work in an office or a bank. Must be dead boring. Well, it's probably a bit more secure than doing a window cleaning around with your half fella like you two.
Hey, sound doing the windows with your half fella. He's got a dead big round, there's loads of cash in it. That's how I could afford to come here. There's not normal doing windows, Ralphie boy.
Well, who does the windows in your house, Toddy? You or your dad?
Me ma.
Oh, that's disgusting, that is. All the skill you possess in a job, and you let your poor old mammy do the windows for you. You might at least bring the chamois out for the poor woman.
Hey, do you make sure she does all the corners, eh, Toddy?
Fuck off you, you fucking jock. And don't you take the piss either. We do your windows as well, remember? You at least have got a job. Not a fucking dolly.
Not a dolly. You and your half-fella still sign on. This might come as a surprise to you, Toddy, but working on the side isn't considered to be proper employment, you know.
Yeah, but at least I'm doing something. I'm not sitting on my ass.
Oh no, but you're talking through it.
never mind, Toddy. There's at least one straight job going on Merseyside at the moment. Manager of Liverpool. You can apply for that when we get home.
Liverpool have to give you an interview as well. Be a bit of competition for Dalglish.
Up your kilt, spot and brain.
I'll tell you something, you two get on really well. Nobody'd ever guess that you were cousins.
Only because me ma's sister married the Mint Rock. Just been fucking buried at the time, like.
Oh, well, that's not nice, eh?
My mother's one of those rare creatures. An English person with intelligence. Well, she wanted the social and the cultural advantages being associated with the Celtic race. She wasn't happy just being a Scouser.
Fuck off! Scousers are the cream, aren't we, Ralph?
Some of us are.
Aye. Me, not you and me.
Do you know what? Some dirty little bastards had a shit in the shower.
The cream, eh, Toddy? You can't even use the toilet properly.
Oh, I wouldn't mean.
Terrible, eh?
Tell the manager.
Yeah, just been down there. He said he'd get it cleaned up, but he had a right cob on about it.
So blame him.
You know what, there's some real animals hanging around.
Yeah.
When I was down there waiting for him, I heard some lads talking about Fagin. He's packed it in.
Go away.
What is it with him?
Yeah, I know. The lads were telling me before. It's bad news, but I hope it doesn't affect the lads tonight.
Yeah, well, they were also saying that Walsh and Lawrence will be fit for the game, so that's a bit of good news.
We'll sail through with those two playing. Champions Europe!
Shut up. There's an album on there.
Ah, so then, let's have a sing song. We don't carry bottles. We don't carry legs. We don't carry ahead of you.
All right, so, all right, that's it. I've had it all. Ouch. Get on your way, you. Come on, Mitch. Get lost with him. If you don't get out now, lad, I'm going to give you a good smack. Get lost.
We're by far the greatest.
Senor Alfred is a man of bollocks.
Well, it's amazing what a couple of babies can do, eh? Say goodbye, Toddy.
Goodbye, Toddy.
I tell you what, I wouldn't fancy being stuck with them two for the rest of the day.
They're not bad lads. In fact, the Scottish lad's pretty bright.
It's a pity we can't say the same about Toddy then, isn't it? Oh, come on, we'll have to get a move on. You've still got the tickets.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Well, let's see them then.
Oh. All right.
Have you seen her? She would have blacked out the Z. Wonder what the score is there.
Yeah, it's probably just for the neutrals, that Z section.
Well, that's where Toddy and his mates are going to be. At least we'll be away from them for the match.
Thank God.
Wonder what sort of a gaff this Ishall Stadium is.
Well, this should be a good ground. They usually pick a good stadium for a big match like this, don't they?
Well, never been to a bad one for a European final. It's got to be as good as any English ground. Well, any first division ground, that is.
I must admit, I'm really looking forward to the game tonight, Ralph. Haven't been to a match now for about 4 months.
Yeah, well, you'd be able to get some more, wouldn't you, if you wasn't working in Saudi?
I've got to earn a living, lad. And you can earn a good living out there as well, you know. I can get you fixed up at the start any time.
Yeah. I wouldn't fancy working in a place like that. I'd rather hang on in Liverpool, see if things pick up.
Jesus, you could be hanging on a hell of a long time, lad. Anyway, the offer still stands if you ever get fed up hanging on.
I know you're only thinking of me welfare, but I'd miss too much if I left Liverpool.
Oh, yeah. Like Liverpool Football Club and your mad arguments in the alehouse. Still, I suppose we can't change the habits of a lifetime.
Oh, yeah, we've got a picture.
Well done. Turn it off now.
I'll leave it.
Let it warm up for after when we come back. Well, I'll tell you what. I'm raring to go now, Eddie. Wait, you'll nearly lift that cup up tonight. Be arse for keeps.
Yes, another bit of history about to be made. Oh, friggin' hell, Ralph, you're not still wearing that old thing, are you?
What do you mean? She had a bit of history getting made, this old thing. I reckon tonight they'll be seeing something special.
Yes.
Come here, lad.
Let's get those eyes, you! Come on, you Reds! Come on, you Reds! Come on, you Reds!
A pitch battle broke out as maybe 1,000 supporters wearing the red of Liverpool burst through the cordon and started to hurl missiles into the retreating Italian supporters.
Oh, there's been a barrier crash down now. There's maybe 200 Italians falling to the ground, and there's going to be an awful crush there. There are people lying underneath the barrier. And clearly these are very dangerous scenes now.
There may be as many as between 10 and 20 dead.
The vast majority of the Liverpool supporters here have been spectators of this violence, but nevertheless, something like 1,000 of them have been involved.
I'm afraid the casualty figure now seems to be somewhat higher than 24. The latest estimates are at least 35 dead and well over 150 injured.
This is a terrible scene, terrible. I feel terrible.
Juventus 1, the Reds 0. Juventus 1, the Reds 0. The Reds 0. The Reds 0.
Do you want a beer?
No.
What's bothering you most, Ralph?
What do you mean?
When we left Ostend for Brussels, people were waving to us. All men and women were giving us the thumbs up and that. On the coach, we were all getting the ale down our necks, having a good time.
I still don't know what you mean.
We've just come back, Ralph, and there's no one waving to us. The old gaff shut up shop, and the only people on the streets are busies.
Say that in, will you, for fuck's sake? There's nothing we can do about it now.
People died at that game tonight.
Some poor bastards actually died there, Ralph. But all you could talk about was a penalty decision.
What did you see, eh? You were the same as me. You seen fuck all. No one around us had any idea about people being dead. None of us knew. All we seen was the match.
The Belgians want to treat us like lepers. That's their fucking problem.
All I seen was the match, and that's all I can talk about.
Well, we all heard the news. We all heard that people had been killed by Liverpool fans.
No, we didn't. We heard that some wall had caved in. And we got told there was a bit of fight before we got to the ground.
Yeah, and that Liverpool fans were involved in the fighting.
Well, we never saw none of the fighting, did we? So it's best for us to wait until we find out exactly what happened.
Yeah, well, whatever happened, it's sick. This was supposed to have been a great day. Oh, this has made a real mockery of it. Oh. Yeah.
Now, you calm down a bit first, mate. Well, we should be singing our heads off now. Having a ball and some halos. I don't know.
It's just the result of the match that's getting to you, isn't it? That's all it is.
What do you expect it to be? I came here to support Liverpool. I came here to see them win. I didn't get what I came for, did I?
Yeah, you're right. It is sick that people died tonight. But I came here for the match. And we lost that. Right from the minute we got to that ground, things went wrong. Fucking pigs die. Any bastard could just walk in. You didn't have to show your tickets or nothing. Police horses on the pitch. Riot police massed in front of us. Fucking marvellous. And there's a handful of Juventus fans acting a twat and they're into the ground holding the game up. Right, cock up.
Oh, aye. It was a cock-up, all right. And it cost people their lives. Football isn't worth dying for, not even when it's a European Cup final.
Football didn't kill anybody.
I don't know what it was, but it wasn't football. I can't understand how the trouble could start, though. In Brussels before the game, we had a good time with the Italians, bevying with them, singing with them. They were decent people. There was no aggro in them. How does the trouble start, Ralph?
I don't know.
We get referees like that bastard tonight. The decisions that he was making, that upsets people.
Oh, for fuck's sake, can't you take your mind off the game just for one minute?
Right, I don't understand what else happened.
More people died.
That's all you've gone on about since we heard about it on the coach. What do you want me to do? I didn't fucking kill him, did I?
If part of the ground suddenly collapses, well, what can I do about that?
But what about the fighting that went on, Alf? What about that?
It happens. There's nothing we can do about it.
Well, you don't seem to realise that it's your sacred football that's to blame. It's not just a game anymore, it's a worn out of some of those characters that go to match.
And that's a load of bollocks. The people that get involved in fighting at a football match will get involved in a fight anyway. Jesus Christ, Eddie. You sound like one of those pricks who writes for the newspapers.
What?
One of those mealy-mouthed bastards who tell us that football hooligans are taking over the game. Getting a grip of the game. Oh, and then he tells us that football's to blame for turning people into hooligans. I'm fucking telling you, Eddie. The fucking nutters came to football, not from it. Football's been going over 100 years. But the shites who get called hooligans, they've only been hanging around the last 10. Don't blame the game, Eddie. Blame the bastards that disrupt it, but don't blame the game.
Well, don't you think the game might attract the shite? I mean, look at us. We've travelled to a foreign country to watch a team play football.
Oh, what's so bad about that?
Oh, but it's not rational, is it? There's too much importance put on a game of football, the value that's placed in a victory. The dickheads who cause the lumber, they're inspired by this need to succeed, Ralph, and they take it to extremes.
It's right. There'll be some soft bastard out there who'll be delighted by what's happened tonight. He'll see those deaths as a victory. Liverpool got beat, but oh boy, did we fuck those eye ties.
What about all the good supporters, eh? What about the thousands who came here tonight and didn't get involved in any trouble? What about them? Are they to blame, Hardy? Because according to you, no one should have been here. Not even yourself. Oh, come on then, Eddie.
Why did you come along today, eh? Tell me that much.
For a good time, that's why I came. Have a few bevvies, have a bit of a laugh. Even enjoy a good game of football. But I wasn't going to let myself be broken-hearted because Liverpool got beat. I still would have enjoyed myself. Yeah, but I know more about Liverpool fans tonight than I did yesterday. You take it all too far. As far as I'm concerned, you can keep Liverpool and football because I want no part of it.
Well, you never had much of a part of it anyway, did you? Oh, let's be honest, Eddie. You've only been to the odd game in your best season. What do you know about Liverpool fans, eh?
I know as much as you. Right.
I admit it. Yeah, I'm a Liverpool nut. They're the only team for me, aren't they? But there's thousands of other Liverpool supporters who love all football. They can even appreciate it when a team beats us by playing better football than us. But they don't go home and batter the wife, kick the kids, or piss on the cat, or do whatever else you seem to think they do.
Well, if they love the football so much, why don't they sort out the bastards who are trying to wreck it for them?
By doing what? Knock shit out of every skinhead you see on the cop? Yeah. Smash someone's face in because he happens to be wearing steel toe caps in his boots? Is that what you want? Become a fucking hooligan to keep away from the game? Is that what you want?
But people died at that game tonight, Ralph. Doesn't that tell you something about your football?
That was bad news tonight, eh?
Yeah, you better specify what you mean, Mitch. That idiot would like to mean the result of the match.
I'm telling you about what happened on the terraces.
Did you see what happened?
Do you mind?
Help yourself. Come on in.
Cheers.
Hey, do you want some of this?
No, thanks. I shall do me fine.
Where's
Toddy? He's down the stair. He's going to ring his folks. Let him know that he's alright. It was a fucking awful thing to happen, eh?
What did happen?
It was mad. I couldn't believe it. There was just no effort for the police to stop it. It should never happen. Know that section we had tickets for? It was full of Italians. And we got to the ground. There's a few police outside the entrance, you know. Shows our tickets and then we went. But when we got inside, seen all your Juventus fans, we went back to the police, asked if we could move to the other section.
Oh, you should have just waltzed into the section. Everybody else did.
I wish we did. So the police did was tell us to get back onto the terraces. One of them even started waving his fucking banners. It was a certainty that there'd be trouble. They were just mixing Liverpool fans in with the Juventus crowd. Never seen anything so stupid. And the ground itself, that wasn't fit for a big match like that.
Well, what caused the wall to collapse? Was that part of the ground too full or something?
See, we got ourselves over by the fence. But we had to make our way through the Italian fans to get to the Liverpool section. But we thought we'd be alright there.
We should have had the whole of that end. Not just two-thirds.
Let's just hear what Mitchie has seen.
It was bad enough having to make our way through the Italians. They were pushing and spitting us and that. When we got over by the fence, things got worse. There was about half a dozen police, so to guard in the fence. They were only interested in what was happening in the Liverpool section. We had Italians coming up to us having a go on that, and the police were doing fuck all about it. And stuff started to get thrown over the fence. Bottles and stones and that. So the Liverpool fans started to shake the fence, trying to get it down. Fucking chaos.
Yeah, Ralph. That's what your football does to people.
Oh, why don't you give it a rest?
You see, all the Italians just started to panic. They all pushed into the far corner of the ground where we'd came in. There was nobody chasing them at the time. They were just trying to get away. It was as if all crushed into each other. It was fucking ridiculous. We were jumping over the barriers at the front. Then some wall, I think, gave way. A couple of minutes later, you could see people getting pulled out from that corner of the ground. and when the crowd thinned out a wee bit, you could see people lying on the terraces. I was worried about Toddy. I thought he might got caught in the crush.
Did you find him?
Aye. He was at the back of the terrace. She helped some old Italian guy who'd been knocked over. Two of us took the old guy down to the front. He had a sore arm and a cut in his head. Well, Toddy wanted to get off then. He didn't even want to stay for the game. I just dragged him into the Liverpool section. Told him not to be so daft. Down at the front, on the running track, there's bodies on the floor. The faces were almost black. There was this one guy. He could only have been about my age. We were covering him with a flag or something. I could see that he'd pissed his trousers. He was dead. What a way to go, eh?
We had no idea about what went on till after the match. We saw the empty terrace next to ours, but we thought that's where the police had evacuated it. You know, because of the fighting. You didn't know about people being dead.
Unless you happened to have been there and seen it off, you wouldn't have realised that it was so bad. A lot of people didn't know about any deaths until after the game.
She's been on the blow to me, I fell, I didn't know it alright.
No, I fell asleep on the telly, did he?
Yeah. Said my man was dead worried.
Yeah, lad. Grab yourself a beer. You deserve one after what you've seen tonight.
No, thanks, Ed. I've had a load today, makes me feel a bit sick.
We all feel a bit sick, lad.
Which was telling us you were helping some our fella when the trouble was going on, eh?
Now, the terrible thing about all this, we'll switch for a ban from Europe now.
It won't help those that died, will it?
That's a fact, right, Anna? It's not going to help the people that we've seen. But you wait for. They are going to come down heavy on Liverpool.
Yeah, all right. I know it was bad tonight. But we shouldn't cop for the law. 20 years we've been in Europe. And this is the first time we've been involved in anything like this. And from what you tell me, Mitch, it doesn't seem to me like it was all our fault.
Yeah, well, if it was down to me, I'd make sure that no British club ever played on the continent again. Oh, I'm fucking well telling you, there's been trouble with all the clubs that have come to Europe nearly every year, and this is going to put the fucking blocks on it.
Well, we haven't been involved in any trouble like that before, have we? And you can't blame all the good supporters for the actions of a couple of head cases. And what about me? Why should I be banned? That's fuck all to do with me.
Ralph, it doesn't even matter a shite if you're a good supporter or a baddie. You're a Liverpudlian. You're guilty by association. When your UEFA start imposing bans, when they start putting their blame out, everyone will suffer.
And what about them? Fucking UEFA. They pit the ground, they put the tickets out. They're more to blame than anybody.
That's a fact, right enough. But UEFA ain't going to put themselves in the dock. Well, just look how anxious they are to put their boot into any British clubs. We had one fucking lunatic at Pighead this season. Just the one. He threw a bottle on a pitch against Rapid Vienna. Didn't hit anybody. But the Austrians may do that, it did.
But it's bad news that someone should throw a bottle in the first place.
No argument, Eddie. None at all. But UEFA ordered a game that we had won to be replayed. All because of one man. One man out of a crowd of 50,000. You see, there's a former footballing politics behind them. Because British clubs have been cleaning up in Europe over the last 7 or 8 years. And you must remember that UEFA is top-heavy with committee men from countries whose teams didn't get a look in. The Germans and the Italians, they dominated European competition years ago. But they're not getting the trophies now. They're making money. Bigger money than any British clubs. But believe me, Ralph, UEFA are gonna fuck Liverpool.
Well, I don't know about the politics of it all. All I know is that people shouldn't die at a football match. And if they do, then someone should be made to pay.
Ah, oh, that's right, Eddie. Just lash out, eh? Any bastard wearing a red and white scarf, they'll do, will he? Well, you're wearing a red and white shirt, lad, and you were there tonight. How much blame you gonna take?
Me?
I'll tell you how much. Fucking none. Because you'll just piss off back to Saudi and tell them all here what a shower of uncivilised bastards we all are in Liverpool, won't you?
Now don't start slagging me off, Ralph. You're fucking quick enough to use the money I earned from your job.
Hey, I never asked for it, lad. I didn't even know you bought the fucking tickets. Now that was just you being flash, wasn't it? Show everyone what a good fella you are, how well off you are. Come on here today, was just another trip abroad for you. Another stamp on your fucking passport. Football doesn't mean nothing to you. Nothing means nothing to you, Eddie. All this accusing others just about par for the course for you. You got out of forts because the unions are fucking things up. You took the money and you ran. Said Liverpool was a dead city when you got your job abroad. This council's ruining our city. You had to go with the blacks when he was troubling the South End. Before them, it was the dockers. And now it's the football fans. But you've never been out of order, have you? You've never had the constructive thing to say in your miserable little life. You know what you are? You're a fucking sun reader. Because all you care about is money, big tits and fucking tinsel.
Yeah, well, that makes me better than you, then. Because I also happen to care about the people that died tonight. All you concerned yourself with is the result and what might happen to your fucking precious Liverpool. So don't start slagging me off for what I care about. You just have to think about what matters most to you. You don't seem to realise there's more to life than a football team. Yeah? You're happy to be stuck in a broken down city with fuck all going for you, just as long as you've got Liverpool Football Club. Well, that's not good enough for me, lad. I want something more out of life than watching a bunch of millionaires kicking a fucking ball around. So don't start slagging me off for not caring and not being constructive. Because I know shit when I see it. And what happened tonight was shit.
All right, all right, shut up now. For fuck's sake, shut up. You're just going on about it. There's nothing anyone can do now, is there?
It's got into him. It's cracking him up.
He didn't want to kill anyone. You just couldn't stand it and let them get away with it. I had to go with them, didn't I? I couldn't help it, I just had to go.
What's he saying, Mitch? What's all this having to go like?
Fuck's sake, Eddie, it was fucking mad out there, you know? It was tough to hold back. I thought you went into the Italians when the Finch came to. We wasn't going to say anything about it to you two.
They were spitting at us. Just coming over and kicking us. One of them had a knife. He was flashing it around. Shouting at us. Laughing at us. The coppers were doing fuck all. When the others went through with the fence, I just went after them. I just wanted to get that bastard with the knife and give him a smack. I just cracked up. I went after anyone. I was booting out at anyone.
Why didn't you get a grip of him? What did you let him carry on like that for?
Christ, he had your hand in seconds. I didn't even see him take off.
Was this our fella? He was trying to get his way up to the back, get away from the trouble. There was a couple of fellas having a go at him. I was going to join him, but he was only an elf fella. He was shouting. He must have been dead scared. I just picked him up and pulled them out the way. Then everyone started to back off. There was all sorts of people at the back and they were pointing and shouting. Everyone was scared then. They were crying and pointing at the corner. It's where the war went. I didn't mean it.
I didn't want anyone to die. I just wanted to get that bastard with the knife.
You got more than the bastard with the knife, didn't you, Ray? You got more than one.
Leave it, Eddie.
Are you happy with what you did?
Fuck's sake,
leave it! Fucking leave it out!
You big bastard, what's all
you want? All right, don't even think about it, Eddie. Stop it!
You happy now, are you? Now you've sorted these two villains out. Now sit down, Toddy, for fuck's sake. Making the place look untidy.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean for anything to happen.
But it did,
Eddie!
Now, if this had got broken, we'd have had a real disaster on our hands, wouldn't we? You got no mixes, Mitch. Fancy it straight?
No, thanks. I'll stick to the beer. That stuff makes you too aggressive.
Well, I won't offer you none, Toddy. You're blubbing, and you want to think you've been battering the fucking gin all day. I'm glad we didn't win the fucking cup. Right, shout a miserable bastard to celebrate with you three. Now, oh, mind you, you're pretty good company in defeat.
Sorry, Mitch. I didn't mean to have a go at you, you know. I just...
See how easy it is, eh? Doesn't take much, does it? To lose your head.
Oh, no. I know that. I can't believe any of what's been going on tonight. I just can't. I think I'll get a wash and get out to a club or something.
You can't.
You what?
Before I was waiting to use the phone, the coppers came in and said we weren't allowed out tonight. Said he didn't want any English fans out in the street in case they caused more trouble.
We didn't cause any...
I'll get this cleaned off here, Ralph. Get it posted back here.
Oh, don't worry about it, Mitch. It's only an handkerchief. Not a £10 note.
Ralph, you won't tell me dad about this, will you?
Well, what's there to tell? What's so interesting about four football fans in a tatty Belgian hotel room?
You don't mean about the match?
You said he saw it on the telly, didn't you?
No, I'm talking about what I've done on the pitch.
Don't worry about it. Time tomorrow comes, there'll be that many people telling their story. Yet our fella know more about it than what we do.
The media boys will have a field day audition. They played the Bradford disaster for all it was worth. This will be the jackpot to them.
One blow after another for football. Suppose the politicians will be right onto it now. Putting the boot in. Thatcher will be on the box. Tell everyone what a shower of bastards we are in Liverpool.
She'll try to get the game won this time for sure. How is it, eh? All of a sudden these people become experts on football. Shouldn't something tragic takes place?
Thatcher never misses a trick, does she? I mean, she even went to Bradford to visit the burnt-out stand. Now, what possible good could that do anybody?
Paying her respects, something like that.
How can she pay her respects to the dead? She doesn't have any for the living. We can do without people like her throwing her oar in. Oh, I'm not saying they shouldn't try to solve the problems, like, but... Most of these politicians... They've never stood on a terrace in their lives. How can they possibly understand what a football fan experiences?
Does it matter who comes up with the solution as long as it works?
No. Not at all. As long as it works. Up to now, though. Nobody has, have they?
I think it'd be good if we could swap scarves at the match.
got us off a Juventus fan before we got on the ground. We were just talking and laughing. Because I couldn't understand him and he couldn't understand me. Then he just pointed to his scarf and pointed to mine. I understood that one. I wonder if he was in that section. Where the trouble was.
Would it have made any difference to you?
Yeah, it would have. I'm gonna keep this thing. I'm gonna keep this for as long as you've had that, Ralph. Might even get to play Juventus again someday.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Now you hang on to it, lad. If nothing else, at least you'll have something happy to remember about today. Yeah, we all act a clown sometimes, don't we? Just a tragedy that you picked today. But you'll remember that as well. And that's something you should never forget. And you, some people will never let you forget it. And I hope you do have that scarf as long as I've had this thing. And I hope it gets to see as many good times and good games as this has seen.
Wish I'd seen something good tonight, though.
Well, you're just going to have to learn to take things a wee bit easier, Toddy. See the Celtic Rangers games? I've been to dozens of those matches. Fucking dozens of them. But I've never been involved in a fight at any Old Firm game. Not the once. I've been called everything to my face, man. My peepest bastard to a hinge cunt. Well, I know the boys who calls me those names. The guys who threaten me. They're not a big football. They're just a nutters who go to the games for the trouble.
Football's okay. You get them bad weeks when your tank's low or you've had another job knocked back. You've got a cold or something like that. And Saturday comes. And you get along to the match. You meet your mates in the spec on the cop. And you have a laugh. Then the game gets going. It turns out to be a cracker. You get really involved. Every tackle. All the headers. The way the ball gets knocked around the park. You get carried away. You give someone a mouthful. Usually the ref or one of the opposition. It'd be one of those games where you play the other team off the park. But you just can't get the ball in the net. Or a game when you think you're never going to score. And then it happens. One of the lads, Daglish, Rushy or Whelan, sticks the ball away. At that moment you shout. And you don't know what you shout. And thousands of others are shouting with you. And there's no unemployment. No job knockbacks. No lousy feeling. Even your fucking cold's gone. That's what it's about. That's why I love the game. Helps me to forget about the real world for a while. That's what frees all the bonus. I know at least once a season I'm going to get that feeling. That's got nothing to do with being right or wrong or winning the arguments out there on the pitch. It's a personal moment of happiness, of ecstasy. It's being shared by 40,000 other people. can't see your hatred like that, lad. You're alone with that. I reckon he wouldn't understand that. She never loved the game.
I take it that you'll be there next season, no way off.
Oh, it seems right. Not many things I can plan in advance, Mitch, but football season's one of them.
And we will get banned from Europe now, Ralph.
Yeah. But don't worry about Liverpool, sorry. They'll survive. Oh, they'll have a good moan about being hard up and that, but then again, they always do, don't they?
Well, if there's no European football, save your money for the World Cup finals.
No, not me, pal. Only flag I'll wave, I'll have a live a bit, Donny. We'll leave the Union Jacks to the National Front, eh?
Parochial, eh?
But no nationalistic. You'd never make a score. What does that mean, parochial?
It means... I just love Liverpool.
So do I. Ralph, tell your kid I'm sorry about tonight. What I did in that.
Why? You're the one who's got to live with it.
Not him.
I remember though. 20 years' time, you still have that scarf. You'll have none. Come out, lads. Shankly era.